teenage girl slid into the backseat of a car and then robbed her date at gunpoint. The victim chased her from Town Center Market onto I-575 and then all the way to Highway 92 in Woodstock. News Since 5, Channel 2's Cobb County Bureau Chief Chris Jose found out the 17-year-old girl's mother turned her in.
All in the family, yeah. It's my understanding that the mom didn't really have an idea of what was going on.
Police say a Monday night date with 17-year-old McQuell Fleming turned out to be a way to allegedly lure 18-year-old Justin Taylor to this Walmart parking lot on Chastain Meadows Parkway.
She hops out of a Dodge Dart, gets in the back of the vehicle, points a gun at him, robs him of the $160 that he'd just been paid from his job.
Police say Taylor chased after the Dodge Dart from the Walmart parking lot onto I-575 and all the way to Highway 92 in Woodstock. I've learned it was a Cherokee County coroner who noticed the speeding cars and called 911. I'm told the coroner followed the cars. The victim stopped, but Fleming kept on driving. Elijah Suggs is a concerned shopper.
I hope he explained to the cops what happened.
He stated that he had just been robbed by somebody that he thought that he was supposed to be going on a date with.
I'm hunting you down till you pull that trigger.
Police say the victim got the tag number. An alert was issued for officers to be on the lookout. They found the car along Barrett Parkway in Kennesaw.
They did a felony traffic stop on the vehicle. It was not the suspect that they were looking for, but in fact, it was her mother.
I've learned the mother led officers to the 17-year-old. According to the police report, she opened her apartment door and called for her two daughters to come outside.
Then I called the mother for her side of this story, but she claimed she had no knowledge of the alleged robbery. But when I read her this police report with her name on it, she hung up on me.
Yo, YouTube, what's going on? Trey back again, hit you with a video. Now this video right here comes out of Georgia. Big shout out to everybody in Georgia holding it down. You already know who you are. This story comes out of Kennesaw, wherever the hell that's at. But anyway, big shout out to you all also, because like I said, Georgia got so many counties and little cities. You don't know what's all there. I think like 120, 150. My people from Georgia, chime in, let us know how many damn little towns and cities do you all have. Because every time I look up another story, another day, you know, it's like another damn city. I'm like, did they just add this damn city to the list? But anyway, we have a very interesting story coming out of Georgia. Yes, you might say, well, damn, all of them be interesting, Trey. Well, thank you. And yes, they do. We have a young little heifer. Yes, you know, I'm going to break it down. I'm going to get all up in this story's ass. Yes, we have a young little heifer who's starting off, what you say, on the wrong foot. Yes, you know how you start out on the wrong foot. You mean you're not doing what you're supposed to do at an early age. In a way that you can tell how somebody would grow up to be later on in life is how they start off when they're younger. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to be a nerd all through your school years, all the way up until you're 20. All of a sudden, you get past 20, then all of a sudden, you're a full-fledged gangster, even though that is very popular in the rap music, because a lot of these guys ain't gangsters anyway. But anyway, it's a sad situation that you would have a woman, a young lady this age. She's not a woman, but a young lady at this age already dipping and dapping and don't even know what's happening. You know, and the fact that it's a 17-year-old girl who decides to rob somebody. Yes, rob a date that she met on Instagram. But this is what I tell you all. You have to be careful. People be all up in your inbox trying to slide up in your DMs. That ain't the only thing they're trying to slide up in. Some of them trying to slide up in your drawers and your panties. And some of them trying to slide up in your damn pocketbooks, your wallets, or your purse. As in this case, she tried to slide up in old boy wallet. Yes, the guy just got paid from his job. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what kind of job he had, but damn, it wasn't that much money. But at least he's trying to work as a young man. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, she wasn't interested in going on a date with him. What she wanted was those ducats. What she wanted was that cabbage, that bread, that euro, that dinero, pesos. You get the picture. But anyway, I'm going to read a snippet from this story, and I'm going to give my opinion. Surely, as we go. Teen robbed man at gunpoint after lure him on Instagram, says cops. You better be careful when people be all up in your inbox talking about, I love you, you the most beautiful thing in the world. You know damn well yourself. Let me just say this. You know damn well if you don't look good and somebody telling you that you look good, but people been calling you ugly your whole life, somebody lying. Either those people that's been in your life all those years calling you ugly, or this person right here that's telling you you're beautiful, and somebody's lying. That's up for you to decide when you look in the mirror. I'm not here to cast judgment or pass judgment on anyone. Anyway, a teenage girl lured a man she met on Instagram to a parking lot in Georgia, where he thought they were meeting for a date, and robbed him at gunpoint. Police said, why would you have to meet at a parking lot? You know what I'm saying? Now, I know this little young heifer don't have a car, because that came out in the story, as you heard the newswoman said. She was basically driving her mama car, trying to hit licks in it. Can I get an amen from somebody? Thank you, whoever said that right there. But she was riding around town trying to get it. Yes, riding around getting it, but trying to get it in the wrong damn way. Instead of her little young ass being somewhere up in the damn store, a TCBY, a Baskin Robbins, or a mall, or any damn where, Walmart trying to work, or Burger King, McDonald's, she decides she want to take the high road in life and just basically rob people out of their money. Like, I ain't got to do shit, I'm just going to take yours. And that's the sad mentality that we have of a lot of people in this country, where they think they don't have to work for a damn dime, they can just take your shit. You feel me? And then something happened to them, y'all be wanting people to cry, do videos on them and all that. Like I said this right here, if you play a stupid game, guess what you're going to win? Somebody said a stupid prize. Let's continue. Now, Maquel Fleming, 17, of Kennesaw, was arrested on July the 17th. Hours, just hours, she didn't even get a chance to even spend $1. Hours after she allegedly held up the 18-year-old man at a Walmart parking lot in Marietta. And big shout out to everybody in Marietta. There's so much shit go down in Marietta. But I'm telling you, when I come to Georgia, I'm passing straight through Marietta. So don't even ask me to stop at Walmart or that little Popeyes y'all got by the highway. I'm not stopping no damn where over there in Marietta. Now, anyway. Now, she hops out of a Dodge Dart. Now, when I heard the Dodge Dart part, I'm like, and no offense to my people out there who got Dodge Dart, because every time I name a car, I got a lot of viewers, so I know of them, I'm going to at least hit somebody on the head with the kind of car they got. And I don't want nobody thinking I'm trying to talk about their damn car, but at the same time, it's not like she was in a damn Charger. It's not like she was in a Challenger. Now, if you was in a Challenger, you try to rob somebody, ain't no way in hell they could have catch you. But what in the hell did you think that you was gonna go in a Dodge Dart? Just cause that damn car named Dart don't mean it's gonna go super fast like a damn dart, like you throwing a dart. No wonder she got her ass caught. She tried to hit a lick and take off running, had a high speed chase in a damn Dodge Dart. If you was in a Challenger XRT or one of them Challengers in the Hellcat version or the Demon, you could have got away, boo-boo, but you probably would have rigged it. That's too much power. Let's keep on. Now, she hops out of a Dodge Dart, gets in the back of the vehicle, points a gun at him, and robs him of the $160 that he had just been paid from his job. Cobb County Police Sergeant Sarah O'Hara told the station. Now, Sarah O'Hara was not bullshit, but at the same time, this guy just got paid that Friday night like Johnny Kim. You know what I'm saying? Got money in his pocket, feeling right. And then this woman, this young girl, I don't know why I keep saying woman, this heifer decides the best thing to do, because she probably could have, hey, let me just keep it real. Can I keep it real with you all? You know I'm going to keep it real. The guy probably would have most likely broke bread with her. He would have spent most likely all the money on her anyway, so it wasn't no need to rob the man of the little $160 damn. And also, is that what it costs right now for your freedom? For the cookie or whatnot? $160? Let me repeat myself again. She could have had it all if she would have just played a part. The guy probably had got the money just to take you somewhere and do some stuff for you. Take you out to eat, go buy you a, you know what I'm saying, a little summer too or whatever. You would have had it all. But no, this what happened when people don't mean you no good. They don't even really think. She's not thinking of the fact that I'm in a damn Dodge Dart. And I don't know what kind of car he was in, because they didn't say. But at the same time, you in a Dart, baby. You ain't going nowhere. You ain't going over 85. Let's continue. Now, determined to get his money back, the victim then drove after Fleming. And I don't blame, I would have drove after her ass too. And you ain't running me in my two-seater or them other ones. But that two-seater, you can hang it up. You gotta be in something fast, baby. You better at least have over 400 horsepower before you try to battle Trey. Let's go on. Now, the guy was determined to get his money back like anybody would. The victim then drove after Fleming, following her onto Interstate 575 and later on State Route 92 in Woodstock. And for those of you in the Georgia area, you know exactly where that's at. Well, a Cherokee County coroner spotted the speeding cars and called the police. And if it wasn't for that coroner, you know what I'm saying, we probably wouldn't even know who did this. We wouldn't even know the little girl was 18 damn years old. And I said little girl, because that's what she is, even though she's 18, out here doing stupid shit like that. You get no respect from me. The coroner followed the cars, and the victim later stopped driving to speak with police, O'Hara said. He stated that he had just been robbed by somebody that he thought he was supposed to be going on a date with, she told the station. Now imagine you having to pull over and tell the police, guys, and you know we full of pride, you know what I'm saying? We supposed to be the beast, the alpha males. We got some betas and some simps out here too. But at the same time, imagine your pride, how much your pride would be crushed if you had to go tell a cop, look, man, I met this fine little young honey on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, even YouTube now. Even YouTube getting it popping. And, you know, she had a backside banging like a Benzie. You feel me? I mean, she was the baddest thing I ever laid my eyes on. But damn, she robbed me. She robbed me. Well, how much did she get out of you? Did she take your credit cards? No, she didn't take the credit cards. Did she take your gold watch and your diamond bracelet? No. She only took $20, but damn, $20 is enough for to get your ass kicked and wind up stinking somewhere. You have people who kills for less. You have people who will whoop your ass and kill your ass just for stepping on their shoes. So that's how my story would have went. I'm like, them $20, I need them $20 back. But imagine how bad and how hurt that guy must have been feeling. And just to sit up here and have to stop to the police and tell them what actually happened, even though he had to stop because the police got involved after the county coroner seen them speeding, chasing each other like Fast and the Furious 9. Anyway, let's go and finish the story up. He stated that he had just been robbed by somebody that he thought he was supposed to be going on a date with. The man gave police Fleming's license plate number. You doggone dumb heifer. You left your damn license plate number. It was your mama license plate number, because that wasn't even your damn car. Because if you had a car, that means you had some kind of income. Because guess what? It costs to keep a car running. You ever heard of maintenance, insurance, gas? It costs to keep a car running. And also, hot as it is right now, AC. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep some cooling, some refrigerant in there, if you know what I mean. So, come to find out, this wasn't even her car. It was her mama car. How in the hell do you do that? Now, you and your mama car riding around to go rob a guy. Why don't you take your hot ass to one of these damn Burger Kings or Pizza Hut somewhere and apply for a damn job? What's wrong? You too good for a damn job? You too good to work? No, you'd rather go out here and watch these damn movies and stuff, these shows, Power, Wire, Empire, got your minds all twisted. Reality don't work that way, boo-boo, as you can see right now. Let's go on finish now. Now, it was not the suspect they were looking for, but in fact, it was her mom, O'Hara said, because they had called her to the car later on, but it was her mom driving the car because it was her mama car and not her car, the Dodge Dart. Yeah, we talking about that little small-ass Dodge Dart. Anyway, the suspect mother then cooperated with investigators by leading them to her daughter. Now, imagine if you the mama and somebody telling you, look, you're under arrest. It wasn't me. I'm not messing with no 17-year-old boy. I'm doing this. I'm a grown woman. You know what I'm saying? You might be talking about one of my kids or something. And then you realize it was your badass, hot ass daughter, the same one that you told to get off of Instagram every night. Babe, you need to get off that Instagram. No, mama, I'm handling business. I'm talking to grandma and whatever. You know, I ain't talking to nobody in the family. She up here going down her list like Santa Claus, checking it twice, finding out who got money and who's naughty and nice. She trying to get that money. She trying to get that bread. That's why I don't respond to shit. So look if I don't respond to you, don't get mad at me, because I got a lot of people, but at the same time, I ain't no damn fool, because I'm telling you, somebody is gonna be a Lovely T or a Tasha K or somebody gonna be doing a story about a YouTuber putting his foot up in somebody's ass, even though he went to the upper room with the victim. But it won't just be me. We both going. Let me go and finish now before I get too deep. She later opened her apartment door and called for her two daughters to come outside. Bring y'all ass here right now. You know how we talk. According to a police report obtained by the station, the mom told police she had no idea about her daughter's alleged plan. O'Hara said, I know she didn't, because guess what one thing mama would have said? And this is how I know the mama innocent. Let me explain myself. One simple thing. Because the mama wouldn't let her use the damn car. You can go do what the hell you want to do, whatever the F you want to do, but you're not finna use my car. We barely let people use our cars, that even with emergency. They can be coming to our house with gunshot wounds. Can I use your car? No, well, we'll drop you off. You know what I'm saying? So, mama ain't had shit to do with that. We ain't going to put mama out there like that. Now, let me go and finish now. Fleming remained in custody on a felony charge of armed robbery at the Cobb County Jail without bond as of Thursday. Mama is not going to bail you out, boo-boo, because mama said, damn it, you should have thought about that shit before you went out here and tried to rob these people. That boy probably would have gave you the $160. And if he wouldn't have gave you the whole $160, he would at least gave you a bill. He would at least gave you $100. But no, you want the whole kit and caboodle. Jail records show that no attorney information was listed, so she don't even have an attorney yet. Poor thing sitting up in there with can't make bail, raising hell, and no attorney to tell her everything will be swell. Let me know what you all think about this video. And if you like that video, press that like button. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. And definitely share this video with your people who think about going out there doing the five-finger discount robberies and stuff like this 1995 and like this 2000. People is not playing no more. Don't you know they got all kinds of tracking devices and stuff? Especially if you got a General Motors car. You ever heard of OnStar? They will track your ass down. So go on out here and think that you're going to make it easy and you're going to come up hard. No, let me tell you something. Get your ass up, find you a hustle, find you a job, and you'll be all right. When I say hustle, I'm talking about legit hustle also. Because let me tell you, the same amount of time that it takes for you to do something wrong, you could be trying to do something right. I'm out.